Everybody, it's the last week we're going to be doing a Project Wednesday video for the rest of the summer, because starting July 5th, our Sunday morning services will resume in person, and in that will be a component of the Gospel Project. So we're going to take a break for the rest of the summer till September from our midweek Project Wednesday, and hopefully by September we will be having Project Wednesday in person as well. Before we get started with our lesson this week, we're talking about Jesus the Healer for this month. I want you guys in your families to talk about what's something amazing or beautiful, or as my son says, bootiful, that you have, that you've seen. Maybe you've gotten to travel somewhere really nice and seen an amazing, piece of nature like the Grand Canyon, or just being up in the mountains, or being out on the water. Maybe it's just a sunset or a rainbow, something that we see pretty much, maybe not rainbows, but sunsets we see all the time. But what's something amazing or beautiful that you have seen? Talk about that in your families, and then we'll continue on. We started our time talking about this because we are all blessed to be able to see. We are all fortunate that we get to look and see the wonders of God's creation. Whether it be a sunset, whether it be going to the beach, whether it be being up in the mountains, or again, maybe on a vacation somewhere where you've seen something amazing. We're fortunate and blessed that we've been able to see God's creation and be astounded by it. But in today's Bible story, we're going to encounter a man who was blind. He could not see. He was born blind, actually, and could not see. And I wonder, what do you think Jesus would end up doing for him? We'll talk about that in a minute. Let's go ahead now, though, and move into our activity sheets, at least getting started on our activity sheets. This week, if you're a younger kid, you're doing the blind draw activity page. And if you're an older kid, you'll be doing a closer look. Go ahead, get started on those activities, and then when you're done, we'll go ahead and continue. Awesome. Well, we're going to move into a fun game. This is kind of like a game we played a few weeks ago. If you remember, the game we played a few weeks ago was you had to stand face to face with somebody in your family, and you had to kind of study them for, you know, 30 seconds or so, and then you turned away from each other, and that person changed one thing about themselves. Then they turned back and you had to identify what that thing was that they changed. This week's kind of going to be similar, except you're going to stand face to face, spend about 30 seconds or so kind of looking at the other person and what they're wearing and what they look like. And then you're going to turn back to back and you're going to start naming things about this person, what their color of their clothes are, what their hair looks like, if they're wearing glasses or not, what kind of shoes they were wearing, whatever it is, you're going to identify as many things about the other person. And whoever can identify more is the winner. And as always, you can play as many times as you want until your heart is satisfied. And then we'll move into the beginning of our lesson. It's really hard sometimes to remember details about somebody, even someone we see all the time. I mean, we might remember eye color or hair color or what their hair looks like or something like that. But sometimes it's hard to remember, you know, what they're wearing or things like that. And again, that's what we're talking about today. We're talking about a man who was born blind that Jesus healed. I wonder when Jesus healed him, what he was most interested about when he finally was able to look and see Jesus. I wonder what features about Jesus stood out to this blind man. I don't know about you. I did not wear glasses for a very long time or contacts, but then about 3 or so years ago, it got so bad. I would watch television. I'd be watching a football game and I would jumble up numbers on the screen. I couldn't tell what numbers were what. And so I finally went and got an eye test, and I was prescribed glasses. And then eventually I didn't like glasses, and so I switched over to contacts. But glasses have been around for over 800 years, which is crazy. And nobody knows who the inventor of eyeglasses are. However, we do know that a guy named Benjamin Franklin, who's on the $100 bill, not a U.S. president, he created the bifocals, which is where each lens on your glasses, because sometimes one eye is maybe stronger than another eye or weaker than another eye. He created the bifocals where each eye could be adjusted so that it would see more correctly. When Benjamin Franklin invented the bifocals, he did something that was extraordinary that helped a great number of people. And it makes me wonder, what the first person who ever put on a pair of glasses thought when he could finally see things that used to be blurry and they were clear, you know, for the first time, or things that maybe the colors weren't very bright, but then you put on those glasses for the first time and the colors brightened up because you could see correctly. Here's the cool thing about Jesus. Jesus encountered this man that was born blind, and Jesus didn't give him a pair of glasses to wear, right? He healed him so that he could see completely. And this goes back to the value that God places on people. God has great value because man and women are the image bearers of God. And that is what our big picture question for this month is. So let's say it together. Why did God create people? God created people to worship Him, love Him, and show glory. God didn't need to create us. God didn't need us to love Him and worship Him. God doesn't need anything. God created us because He loves and He is good. And God wanted to share his goodness and his love with us so that we could have a relationship with him. God, when we are living out our lives the way we're created to be, we get to worship and be blessed by the Lord. Over the last several weeks, we've seen many examples of God's goodness and his love for us through the healing ministry of Jesus. And here's three of the things that we've learned. First, we learned Jesus healed 10 men and one was saved. Then we learned Jesus healed a woman and raised a girl from the dead. And last week, we learned that Jesus healed a man who could not walk. This week, we're going to wrap up the healing ministry of Jesus. By the way, we've barely scratched the surface on the healing ministry of Jesus, but these are just four great stories that we've looked at. But this week, we're going to wrap up the healing portion of Jesus' ministry by looking at the moment in the time in history when Jesus healed a man born blind. The anticipation is over. Let's check it out.
Jesus was walking with his disciples when he saw a man who had been born blind. The disciples asked, "Teacher, why was this man born blind? Did this happen because of his sin or his parents' sin?" Jesus answered, "Neither his sin nor his parents' sin caused this. This man was born blind so that people could see God's power through him. Jesus would be on earth for a short time, so he healed people to show what God is like. Jesus said, "While I am in the world, I am the light of the world." Then Jesus spit on the ground and made mud. He put the mud on the eyes of the man who was blind. "Go and wash in the pool of Siloam," Jesus instructed. The man went and washed.
Wow.
When he came back, he could see. The man's neighbors were amazed. They took the man to the religious leaders and they asked him how he was healed. "A man put mud on my eyes. I washed and now I can see," he said. The religious leaders were upset because Jesus had healed on the Sabbath again. They did not want to believe that Jesus could give sight to people who were blind. Over and over again, the man who was healed told the religious leaders what happened. The man believed Jesus must have come from God. But the religious leaders threw the man out of the synagogue. Jesus came to the man again and asked, "Do you believe in the Son of Man?" The man answered, "Tell me who he is so I can believe in him." "You have already seen him," Jesus replied. "The Son of Man is talking to you now." The man said, "I believe, Lord," and he worshiped Jesus. Our sin makes us unable to see the truth about God. Jesus came as a light in a dark world. He came to give us sight, true understanding of God and his kingdom. Those who trust in Jesus see who he is and worship him.
Our story point this week is Jesus gave sight to a man who was blind. This story gives us great news about pain, sickness, and brokenness in the world. See, a lot of times we think that all of these things that happen because people do wrong things and make bad choices. But in our story today, we saw that that wasn't the case. That the man who was born blind, Jesus' own disciples thought it was because either the man had sinned or his parents had sinned, but Jesus said, no. This is for the glory of God. See, oftentimes, maybe we do things, we sin and we make mistakes, and it leads to some suffering because sin, that's the pattern of sin. It leads to destruction and it leads to suffering. But not all the time do we go through difficult circumstances simply because of our sin or even sin in general. You see, this man was born blind because at this moment in history, Jesus was going to come and heal him. And we saw that when this man was healed from his being blind and was given his sight, that he trusted and had faith that Jesus was the Messiah. And when the Pharisees didn't buy it and didn't believe it, Jesus said, hey, guess what? You are the ones that are blind. And he wasn't talking about physical blindness, like not being able to see. He was saying spiritually, hey, I'm the Messiah, right? Jesus is saying, I'm the Messiah. I'm here. I'm the one that all of our scriptures have pointed to, what we today call the Old Testament, but at that point was the scriptures. I'm the one that they pointed to. And you're blind. You're not seeing it. Much like the Pharisees, you and I were blind, and some of us still are. And when I talk about that, I'm not talking about physical blindness, but I'm talking about spiritual blindness. That just like the Pharisees, either we were blind, we did not yet see who Jesus truly was, or we're still blind, we've heard about Jesus, but we've yet to trust and put our faith in him. Jesus came to this earth to restore sight to the spiritually blind. That's why when we sing the song, the old hymn, one of the most popular songs of all time, whether someone's a Christian or not, they probably know or at least have heard Amazing Grace. The song says, I once was blind, but now I see. And that's what it's talking about, spiritual blindness. Jesus came to restore that. And when we place our faith in Jesus, he heals us of our spiritual blindness and gives us the ability to see him for who he truly is, our wonderful and amazing Savior. This blind man probably felt a lot of things. I've never been blind, so I can't possibly imagine. But I would imagine there were moments where he felt hopeless and alone. And as we move into our questions from kids video, I want you to first talk about, how do you feel when you feel alone? Like when you feel like you're alone, you're by yourself, you're in a tough situation, you feel like you don't have anyone else around you, what feelings does that give you? And I want you to talk about then, what are ways that you can help people who are feeling alone or hopeless? How can you encourage them? Talk about that in your families, and then we'll watch our questions from kids video.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Damien from San Anselmo, California asks,
what should I do if God seems far away during hard times?
Great question, and I think we all experience that at times, where we're going through a season of life and God just seems really distant. Usually that is when we're going through something difficult, some adversity or just a situation where we just find ourselves being sad a lot or troubled. And it feels like God is distant. Now notice the word I just said there, it feels that way. So here's the first thing we have to remember, that God is never distant. He is always there with us. God is omnipresent. That's the big word for present everywhere at once. And so he's always with us. And if we've trusted in Christ, we have the Holy Spirit within us. So he's very present with us in that regard. So even if God feels distant, here's the one thing we can do. We can speak God's truth into our minds and our hearts and remind ourselves that he has not gone anywhere. He is right there with us, and that's good news. The other thing is this, that God feels distant at times, not because he has pulled away from us, but sometimes we've taken our eyes off of him. And so in my life, I know the times that God feels distant, it's because I've not been spending time reading the Bible as much. I've not been praying as much. Maybe I've not been worshiping God as much. And so one of the things I can do, and I need to do when God feels distant, is I need to draw back toward him. I need to read more of scripture. I need to worship more and pray more. And the amazing thing happens every time when I start doing that, God no longer feels distant. He feels like he's right there where he's always been. And so I want to encourage you to do that. When he feels distant, know he's not distant. And what can you do to draw back to him? And you do those things. So got a question back for you. How can you encourage someone who feels alone or has lost hope?
This is our last week with our key passage of Isaiah 53, 4 and 5. So let's say it together. Yet he himself bore our sicknesses and he carried our pains. But we in turn regarded him stricken, struck down by God and afflicted. But he was pierced because of our rebellion, crushed because of our iniquities. Punishment for our peace was on him, and we are healed by his wounds. Let's sing our theme song for the month one last time, By His Wounds. Guys, thank you so much for joining me again. A reminder, this is the last Project Wednesday video that we'll do for the summer. Come September, we'll have it in person as long as nothing changes, and we'll get to enjoy being together again. We're going to close with a word of prayer. Don't forget to continue to finish up your activity sheets for this week. Miss Chris is going to email the activity sheets for the next month here soon. And be looking on Sunday mornings for our gospel project video in our Sunday morning service. Let's pray, and then we'll sing one more song, Won't Worry About a Thing. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the incredible story of when you healed a blind man. And God, it's hard for us to imagine what it would be like to be physically blind, Lord, but we all know what it's like to be spiritually blind, to not have a relationship with you, to not know who Jesus is, or that Jesus is our Messiah, that Jesus loves us, that you love us. And Lord, I pray that if there's any who have not yet began a relationship with you, that they would do that today. Lord, I pray that you would continue to keep our families safe, Lord, and continue to allow them just a great summer, spending time together and growing together as a family and growing in a relationship with you. In your name we pray, amen. Have a great week. Ha ha ha!
and he loved me first. He rescued me when I was in a lurch, and I won't worry about a thing. To the left, I'll fly, fly, fly. To the right, I'll glide, glide, glide. Oh, and I won't worry about a thing. I'm gonna swoop down low, 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 then I'll soar up high, high, high. Oh, and I won't worry about a thing. Like a bird in the big blue.